Today we'll do, I think, the causes or the effects of air pollution and what we can do to reduce air pollution. The effects, I think, first is that our ozone layer is getting damaged because it is our protective shield from the UV rays that is been radiated by the sun, and this ozone layer protects us from that. But chlorofluorocarbon, the notes of which I've already given to you before, from refrigerators, AC machines, deodorants, are slowly destroying the ozone layer, and also the nitrogen that is emitted from the jets, the nuclear explosions also harms our ozone layer. And as the ozone, as this emission of these gases are increasing day by day. Why it is increasing? Because more people are using refrigerators. And why more people? Because we have more population. So as it is, the level of these gases are increasing, emission of these gases, it is thinning the layers day by day, and the ultraviolet rays are actually reaching the earth, which is causing various skin and optical diseases. And the agricultural production is decreasing as chlorophyll that is in the tree leaves are being damaged. Many plants and animals are facing extinction as a result of this. Next is the acid rain water. So I think this acid rain I have discussed in details. So this carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and nitrogen oxide, sulfur dioxide, they are all emitted from the vehicles, factories, they are all reacting with the oxygen and the moisture in the air to produce acid. And soil and trees are also affected by this acid present in the rainwater. So the creatures, the aquatic animals, they are having a very severe or perishable life. Much damage is also caused to the various statues and monuments which are made up of marbles. Okay, next is the greenhouse effect, the notes of which are clear, and I've discussed about this. This heat which is reaches the earth from the sun is subpumped, is radiated back to space at night. But the greenhouse gases like the carbon dioxide, methane, nitrogen oxide, and water vapor, they are present in the air and they absorb some amount of heat and radiate the rest to the space. Consequently, the excess heat it is produced in the atmosphere cannot be actually radiated back to the where they are entrapped, and which causes global warming. And that's why, like, even in the winters we are not facing that cold chill winters. Sometimes we do, but majority of them no. Why? Because of this greenhouse effect. Next is, how can we actually reduce air pollution? Now there is at page 69, there in the small bracket it is written special fact about the greenhouse. Now, or what is a greenhouse actually? Now you must have seen some big gardens or anybody's place, like there is a glass house that is made, and inside that few trees are grown. Especially it is done in the very cold countries. Why? Because this glass house allows the sunlight to get into it, but it does not allow the heat to pass out. So what happens, the trees which are inside or the plants which are inside get the adequate amount of warmth for their growth. So you have lot of varieties of trees which are grown inside the glass house, even in the severe climate or in the cold countries. Next we go on to the effects of the, or what is the measure that we can take to reduce air pollution. Now, measures of air pollution, reduce air pollution. First is that the intensity of air pollution can be reduced if we travel by bus or train instead of our own cars. Now many people can travel in a public transport all at a go, many people in buses, so the air would be less polluted because a single bus can commute how many, lot of passengers, say 40 passengers. But if you eat 40 passengers go by the private means of transport, then 40 cars or motorbikes are required. So how much air or how much pollution is producing? Then again, you can reduce if we use vehicles like bicycle, electric trains, trams. So what happens? The smoke release in the atmosphere is less. Even in the very advanced countries like Japan, they have started or they are using bicycles at their place to stop pollution, because Japan is the most electronic or the biggest electronic place in the whole world. All kind of electronic items are made in Japan, and if those products are made in Japan, it is the most authentic and the best, and there is no chances of getting defect. So the country which is so much technically advanced in electronics naturally will have the bestest of the cars to produce, but they have their own latest design cars, but they use vehicles or trams or monorails which runs on electricity. So the smoke, it is absolutely smoke free. So you breathe fresh air and chances of air pollution is at the minimum. Then cars with very old engines, like a car or any vehicle for in that, as a matter of fact, if it is not going under maintenance, then the first what happens, the engine becomes old. You're not oiling it, you're not giving it to their proper service centers. So whenever you start an old car, what happens, it gives a huge amount of black smoke in the air, which is not at all expected. So now in recent times, the engines which are made are less polluting and manufactured by the advanced technology is used to manufacture those. Then factories and industrial plants should be located far away from the residential areas, and the waste material produced, they should also be treated fine, and there should be recycling of goods. If required, we should fell big trees instead of uprooting small plants and trees, and we may plant a big tree also. Non-conventional use of non-conventional energies like tidal power, wind energy, solar energy, these should also be utilized instead of conventional energies which are likely to get depleted in new time, like coal, petrol, diesel, etc.